Good evening to one and all. This is Shishkalagar, physics teacher. Today I am going to demonstrate an activity to understand the formation of images by convex lens. The apparatus required: one convex lens of focal length 10 cm, one lens holder, screen, scale, pencil, candle, matchbox. Let us see the procedure. First we have to place this convex lens on lens holder. We know that the midpoint of this lens is called optical center. So I am placing this lens here and noted that the midpoint represented by O, which is optical center. We know that convex lens has two refracting surfaces, so it has two focus points which are equidistant from this lens. I marked as F1, F2. These two are focus points, and also I marked 2F1 and 2F2 positions, which are twice of the focal length from optical center. And the line joining this optical center F1, F2, this is called principal axis. So this is the optical center, which is the midpoint of the lens, and the distance from optical center to F1 or F2, which is equals to focal length. The focal length of this lens is 10 cm. So this is 10 cm. It is also 10 cm. And 2F1, 2F2 are the positions which are 20 cm, means twice of the focal length from optical center. But please remember, here 2F1, 2F2 are the positions which are twice of the focal length from optical center. But 2F1, 2F2 are not center of curvature of this lens, which means R is equal to 2F, that is radius of curvature is twice of the focal length, is not applicable to lenses. It is only applicable to mirrors. The focal length of lens depends upon radius of curvature and refractive index of this lens. Now let us see different situations of formation of image by convex lens. Case 1, when the object is placed at infinite distance. Here I am using the candle, which is an object. So we know that when the object is placed at infinite, I am placing the candle very very far away, that is treated as infinite distance. See here, I adjust the position of the screen. Just we are observing image on the screen. So now object is located at infinite distance. Image forms at focus, which is located on another side of this lens. If we observe the image on the screen, that is real image, because it captured on screen, so it is real image and point sized image. Compared to object size, image is very very small. It is like a point, so it is called point size. This is case 1. Case 1 tells that when an object is at infinite, image forms at focus, the nature of the image is real and point sized. Now let us see case 2. When the object is placed beyond 2F1. So the object is placed between 2F1 and infinite. See here, I placed the object beyond 2F1, which means in between infinite and 2F1. Where will be the image forms? To get a sharp image, I am adjusting the screen. See here, when the object is placed beyond 2F1, image forms between F2 and 2F2. See here. So when the object is beyond 2F1, location of the image is between F2 and 2F2. And the nature of the image is We are observing the image on screen, so it is real image and inverted image. Just you compare the image with respect to object, it is inverted. And it is diminished image. Compared to object, image size is smaller. That's why it is named as diminished image. So, when the object is placed between beyond 2F1, image forms between F2 and 2F2. The nature of the image is real, inverted and diminished. This is second case. Now, let us see case 3. That is, when the object is placed on 2F1. On 2F or 2F1. I am adjusting the position of screen. See. When the object is placed on 2F1, image forms on 2F2. Image forms at 2F2. The nature of the image is real, inverted and same size. If we observe the size of the image with respect to size of the object, both are same. So, to get a same size real image, we have to place the object at a distance of twice of the focal length, 2F distance. Here, object is located at a twice of the focal length, that is 20 centimeters, and image also forms on another side of the lens at a distance of 20 centimeters, which is real, inverted and same size. Again, please remember this 2F1, 2F2 are the positions which are 20 centimeter, that is twice of the focal length from optical center, but they are not center of curvature for this lens. Okay. Now, case 4, when the object is placed between F1 and 2F1, in between focus and twice of the focus. Now, to get a sharp image, I am adjusting the screen. See here. When the object is placed between F1 and 2F1, image forms beyond 2F2. The nature of the image is real, inverted and enlarged. Means, compared to the size of the object, image size is very very large. So, when the object is placed between F1 and 2F1, image forms beyond 2F2. The nature is real, inverted and enlarged. Now, let us see case 5. Means, object is placed on focus. Now, see here. I'm adjusting this. See here. We are observing highly magnified image, that is real inverted and highly magnified, which forms very far away. See here. Means, when the object is at focus, image forms at infinite distance. Very very far away, we treated it as infinite and the nature of the image is real image, inverted image and highly magnified. Compared to size of the object, image size is very very large, that's why it is said to be highly magnified. Now, let us see last case, sixth case. When the object is placed between optical center and focus. When the object is placed between optical center and one of the focus, just you see no image obtained on screen. But if we look into the lens, we are observing, just you observe, virtual enlarged erect image. The image is same side of the object, behind the lens, behind the object, and the nature is erect, that is straight and enlarged. Compared to size of the object, image size is very very large, erect image, which cannot be observed on screen, so it is virtual. So to get a virtual erect enlarged image by using convex lens, the object must be placed between optical center and one of the focus. This is one of the virtual case of convex lens. Due to this property, convex lens is used as a magnifying lens or simple microscope.